steel. Let's break it down. S is safety and security. Steel gives us the peace of mind we enjoy each and every day. T, technology. Today's steel is the result of continuous innovation. Steel is as much as 6 times stronger than it was just a decade ago. E, because we're environmental champions, committed to utilizing iron and steel making technologies that ensure our industry remains a leader in energy efficiency. E, that's economic driver. Our industry plays an indispensable role in the strength of the economy. L, we're leaders. North American Steel continues to lead the way in quality, efficiency, and productivity. Steel, it's clever in so many ways, and its strengths are emboldened by the American Iron and Steel Institute. AISI is working to ensure the industry has a voice in Washington, as trusted and unwavering as the products our members create. Because no matter how you look at it, progress relies upon the ingenuity of steel. We ask this year's award winners and retiring committee chairs to share their perspectives as we celebrate them for their contributions to the industry and to the spirit of progress embodied in North American Steel.
What has inspired me to work in the steel industry is the fact that even though the steel industry has a long history, it is a very interesting area for researcher and engineer to develop the new product which can meet the requirement of the customer in the 21st century.
As a young engineer coming into the industry straight out of graduate school, I found that the industry was really primed for innovation. And what I quickly learned was that good ideas would quickly be picked up and really drive innovation into the marketplace.
Steel has stood the test of time in the automotive industry. We've come a long way from the plain carbon steels used in the past as steel alloys with increased strength and ductility continue to be developed. Increasing microstructural complexity now requires some of the most sophisticated experimental tools in the world.
Access to many of these tools has been made possible through collaborations with the U.S. Department of Energy labs, opening up the frontiers of steel research in the U.S. and leading to new advancements in the material science of steels, which holds great promise for future automotive alloys.
Steel technology has also advanced with the commercialization of thin slab casting or compact strip production. This technology has allowed the entry of mini mills into the light flat roll market and supported the concept of lean manufacturing.
Our research team was entrusted with the task of developing 1180 megapascal tensile strength dual face steel with high tensile ductility and a high resistance to shear edge cracking.
As a team, we different engineers specialized in different areas, working together to provide the super strong and super ductile steels.
What we reported in this paper is actually the first time we believe that we couple the in situ measurement of strain with phase transformation. We didn't do just the overall gauge length strain measurement. This is the strain at the beam point. We believe that accurate measurement of that will help the development of the future generation of steel.
Steel is a very complex and interesting materials, and so we can tailor the processing parameters to develop steels with good properties for various applications.
The research I did for my paper was related to clean steel production and how do we tailor the inclusions in the steel based on the final products that we're producing.
The industry's response to competing materials, and specifically aluminum, I think the way the industry has worked together in the automotive market, along with SMDI's help and how we educate not only OEMs, but even the broader consumer base about the strengths of steel. I think it's been tremendous the way the industry has partnered to advance public awareness.
We've seen a tremendous amount of value in collaborating between the steel industry and the automotive industry, really trying to address some fundamental issues that we have as an industry. Where you look at where we try to go from safety standards to CO2 standards, which has driven our lightweighting efforts to manufacturability, recyclability, on. That collaboration has been key to making progress in all those spaces. Frankly, we're excited to see where it continues.
So when you talk about the future of the steel industry, I love to point to the data that one of our colleagues put together some time ago where he tracked the number of automotive commercial grades for steel, and you saw this continued escalation where, if I recall the numbers right, we're at about 100 grades of steel for the automotive industry around the turn of the century, 2000 to about 2015. We had 150, 200 grades. We essentially doubled. What was exciting about that is, being the Vice President of Research and Innovation, I could still look down the pipeline and I could still see how much more was coming.
What I find really interesting about the steel industry and steel industry research is that we have to bring innovation to an industry that's been around for a long time. And it's critical that we continue developing products that can be applied to make cars lighter, to make cars safer. By doing projects like this, we are keeping our steel industry, the North American steel industry, competitive in a global marketplace.